Howdy. In this segment, we're going to look at analyzing cost behavior. Now, if you'll recall, accountants usually assume that costs are linear, and economists will often consider them to be curvilinear. But remember, we are looking at our cost over a narrow range of activity called the relevant range, and it's in the short run, so we assume it can be approximated with a straight line. Now, the equation for a line, total cost equal total variable cost plus total fixed cost. This is going to be the basis for our analysis. Now, if you take that equation and break it down further, total cost will equal variable cost per unit of activity times activity plus total fixed cost. So you'll note that total variable costs are dependent on activity. Now, looking at this equation, what that means is that mixed costs will need to be separated into their variable and fixed components for us to be able to analyze the cost. There are four methods for analyzing cost behavior. The first one is account analysis, and that's simply where the analyst would look at a list of costs, and based on their prior knowledge and patterns that they see in the data, they would just say, well, rent looks like a fixed cost, labor looks like a variable cost, and they would just approximate what they think the costs look like. Now, the scattergraph method, you will take historical observations and plot them and fit a line so that you minimize the deviations. So if we had cost on the vertical axis and activity on the horizontal axis, and we plotted these four data points, we could minimize the deviations with a line that looks something like this. And then you can solve for the variable and fixed components of that line, the slope and the y-intercept. Now, this method is especially useful if we were to graph data that looked like this. It would be very difficult to fit a line to that to minimize the deviations. So we might assume that the cost is not really related to the activity that we have measured. So this would tell us that we're on the wrong track. Now, the high-low method, this is the method we're going to use in this class, and it uses historical or projected information to find the variable and fixed components. This method is also called the TwoPoint Method. To use this method, the first thing you do is calculate the variable cost per unit of activity. The formula to do this is take the high cost minus the low cost in the numerator and divide by high activity minus low activity in the denominator. So you're taking the greatest deviation that you see in your data set. Then you can use the total cost equation to solve for total fixed costs. This is the total cost equation: variable cost per unit times number of units plus total fixed cost. Note that when you plug into this formula to solve for the fixed costs, you will want to use high cost and high activity or low cost and low activity. For now, I would just get that into your notes, and you will understand it better after we do an example. The idea is you don't want to use the intermediate observations. You want to use the highs or the lows. The least squares or regression method, this is a mathematical model that minimizes the deviations to determine the variable and fixed components of a cost. This one is the most accurate, but you are not responsible for these calculations in this class. We'll leave that for your stat course. Right, in the next segment, we will work an example on how to determine the fixed and variable components of a cost using the high-low method. So stay tuned.